From beautiful Colonial Village lanes, this is the 1989 Akron Open. Hello everyone, I'm Jim Mitchell and I'll be doing your play-by-play for this, the 10th renewal of this most prestigious event. 96 players started the tournament and tonight we're going to see the top five of the area's best players vying for the title of the Akron Open and a check for $1,700. And with me, I have two special color commentators. With me first is a two-time Stark County Masters champion and Ohio State champion, Dickie Barger.
Well, thanks very much, Jim. And once again, it's a pleasure to be back here at beautiful Colonial Lanes. And what a high-scoring tournament we've had this weekend. Unbelievable scores, taking an average of over 230 just to make the television show. So we're looking for some big scores tonight.
Thanks, you, Dickie. And also, we have a special color commentator tonight. He won the inaugural Akron Open back in 1980. Is now a full-time touring professional, Ronnie Bell. Ron?
Thanks, Jim. I tell you, it's going to be an exciting event, and I look forward to some high scores, like Dickie says, but I think look for this left lane to give these guys a little bit of a problem.
Okay, you heard it from all the champions. Now let's meet the starting five.
And thanks very much, Jim. And with me is the fifth place qualifier, Gary Rebillot. And Gary, you got a tough field to go after tonight.
Yeah, the tough field, and if I make good shots, I think I can win tonight.
Well, he's got to go through four of the best bowlers in the area, and we've had high scoring all week, so look for some big things out of this rather short guy.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen, with the fourth place qualifier, Tom Johns. Tom, you were here last year. This is your second year in a row. Do you think the experience will help you?
Well, I think the experience is going to help me, Ronnie, but it's a tough field to go through. These are all talented players.
True story right there, bowling fans.
Thanks very much, Ron. And with me, I've got the third place qualifier, Kerry Barbera. And Kerry, you're defending, not the defending champion, but you've won here before. What are your chances this year?
Well, I like this shot. I think I'll have a good shot at maybe making it here again.
Well, this guy's won here before. He's proved himself. So I think he's got a real good opportunity. Back to you, Jim.
1981, Tim Malsas won the Akron Open 8 years later. He was 19 years old at the time, Tim, right? What do you think your chances are of winning this year's tournament?
Well, I feel pretty confident right now, though I do have to go through two great players. I mean, Ken Konzo's averaged 246. He's going to be tough to beat if I make it to the championship round.
Banzi averaged 240 for this tournament. He's got a good chance of winning it again.
With me, ladies and gentlemen, is the tournament leader, Kenny Konzo's. Kenny, you led the tournament all weekend. Now it's just one game for the title. How do you feel you're going to do tonight?
Well, I feel I should do pretty good. I just got to stay loose and throw clean shots. Hopefully I catch a few strikes.
Well, we wish you the very best, Kenny. One game, ladies and gentlemen, for $1,700 in the most prestigious tournament in the Akron area.
Okay, with me is the general manager of Colonial Village Lanes and the tournament director and founder, Rick Davis. Rick, another fine tournament.
Well, thank you, Jim. It's always a pleasure to run the Akron Open. This being the 10th one, I'm really happy with the way it's come and progressed after all these years. I'm looking for a fine show.
You know, if the qualifying round is any indication as to the excitement that you're going to see tonight, ought to be a really an exciting evening.
I think we're going to see high scores. I can't predict the winner, but I know they're going to be bowling well.
Okay, we've met the starting five. Now let's get right to the action. Gary Rebillot now working on three in a row, coming up in frame number six. Got to have this strike just to maintain the tie. Gary Rebillot averaged 231 for this tournament. That's for 18 games. Unbelievable statistics. The pitch. Unbelievable pitch.
Well, I mean, Jimmy, he just, you know, he made that adjustment after those two soft tens, the first two frames. He went right at him. Rebillot is a true veteran and a word of veteran, bowling on a tour over 20 years ago. So, you know, at a young man, he was a star. So, I look for this to be a very, very close match, as you can see it is.
Gary Rebillot coming up in frame number seven, working on four in a row. Gary Rebillot had one of three 300s that were bowled this week in the Akron Open. Make it number five.
Boy, what a great shot there. He's taking a lead, and he's putting the pressure back on Tom. But we expected this. We expected high scores, close games, and it's great for the fans.
You know, 2 years ago, we started out our telecast with a 279 tie, gentlemen. Looks like we are just about ready to have another one.
Following those footsteps, Jimmy, and Tommy Johns on lane 22. Working on three back.
Tommy Johns Got to have a strike to maintain this tie, and there it is. He's got that ball working. Tommy Johns is doesn't have a lot of tournament titles to his credit, but like we did say, this is his second year in a row that he's made the top five in the Akron Open. He was on the winning team of the Budweiser League of Masters in the inaugural year 3 years ago. He has three 300s to his credit and a one series of 800 or better. That was a series of 8-10. Coming up in frame number 8, the 33-year-old from Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio, Tommy Johns. A little light that time.
Well, he just didn't make a good shot, and that's what I was talking about a little bit earlier, Jimmy, about him waiting on a swing. He got a little fast with the feet that time, and with his speed, if he gets the ball going to the right, you know, it's just not going to get back. And as you saw, that ball slid by the head pin, and he left a difficult 2-4-8, a double wood spare.
It's also a difficult spare, plus the fact that he's lost three pins in count, so that gives Gary Rebillot just a few more pins to play with. Going for the conversion, Tommy Johns to 2-4-8, easily made.
That's a big spare for him, Jim. It still keeps him a little bit down in the count, but he's right in this match.
Right now, Gary Rebillot coming up in frame number 8 here in the 1989 Akron Open. He's got a 5 strikes in a row. This will give him a 12-10 lead right now, taking a little extra time. Watch this nice, smooth style of Gary Rebillot from Canton, Ohio. Nice pendulum arm swing. Looks real good. Wow. Unbelievable.
He saw the 5.5 that time. Unbelievable the way these players are performing. And just the great scores that we had all day and yesterday. Just tremendous scoring here at Colonial Lanes. And a lot has to be said for the job that the staff of Rick Davis has done here. And you can tell from the results that they're getting from the scores.
Gary Rebillot bowling in the ninth frame. Got 6 in a row. Going for number 7, the all-important ninth frame. Looks good. A little light. Gets the action off the wall, but that time he just didn't carry out to 7.
Well, he got it a little, like you said, to the right a little bit, and he didn't have the real good roll on it, but he threw that big bagger in the middle there, and he's put a lot of pressure on Tommy Johns, but that's what Tommy Johns has been doing all weekend, is responding to the pressure, so this match is not over yet.
Gary Rebillot to convert the 7 pin. Does it well in the ninth frame. Right now, gentlemen, with the situation is that Gary Rebillot is going off at a 2.48 pace. Tommy Johns can shoot 256, so anything can happen right now. But Tommy Johns is in a must-strike situation already. Bowling on lane 22 here in the Akron Open, Tommy Johns. Looks good. All right, Ronnie, that sets up some interesting possibilities.
Absolutely, Jim. The way it looks right now, Gary Rebillot can strike out. He really locks out Tommy Johns, but there's nothing worse than seeing a guy striking ahead of you. Tommy Johns right now, he's going to have to strike out to put the pressure on Gary Rebillot and force him to strike out.
The situation here, we come up in the 10th frame, the game number 1 here in the Akron Open. Tommy Johns is 196 through the 8th frame with the strike working in the 9th. A possibility of 256. Gary Rebillot can get a possibility of 258. 10th frame, week 10.
Not a good shot for Tommy. I mean, and don't get me wrong, I mean, he just didn't get the good lift on it. He knew it when he threw it. You could tell a little disgust in his, as he walked back. He left the flat 10. He's got to make this.
Tommy Johns qualified in the 6th position after the 12-game qualifier and moved into that number 4 spot for a telecast. Averaged 232 for the 18-game tournament as he converts his spare in the 10th frame, which gives him 216 through the 9th frame with the spare working, possibility of 236. Like we said, he averaged 232 for the 18-game tournament. Right now, gentlemen, the winner of this match will go on to meet Kerry Barbera, but the loser of the match will receive $500. Going for the fill ball.
That was a good shot, Jim. Believe it or not, we still get the possibility of a tie. If Gary Rebillot should happen to throw an 8-count split and just get one, we've got the tie ball game just like we had last year on the first match. So anything can still happen, especially you Lions fans out there. Don't be afraid to
Gary Rebillot come up in frame number 10 here in the first game of the 1989 Akron Open. He needs any kind of a mark if he strikes on this ball. He is a winner. And it looks real good. Looks real good. And there's your winner, ladies and gentlemen. Coming in a little light. The best he can shoot is 258, but it's irrelevant. He will win this match. He will go on to meet Gary Barbera. Tommy Johns will finish in the number five position. Tommy will pick up a check for $500. So, again, for the second year in a row, Tommy Johns finishes in that fifth position as we watch Gary Rebillot throw his second strike here in the 10th frame of the 1989 Akron Open. With a field ball here, he will shoot 258, which is about 20 pins over his tournament average.
Well, as we predicted, Jimmy, high scores, and Gary Rebillot finishes him off, 250. We jinxed him a little there, 255.
255, Gary Rebillot, the winner of the first game. He defeats Tommy Johns, who shot a fine 235. So now we're waiting for Gary Barbera to come up, and he's going to take his practice. So we're going to be back with the next game right after this. Gary's got some nice stats on his bio sheet here. 12 games of 300 or better and 6 series of 800 or better with a high of 844. As we said, Gary is the 1986 Akron Open champion, so he's been down this road a little bit, bowling in the first frame, lane 22, here at the Colonial Village Lanes. Going to convert the 1-2-8. He's got to cross over a little bit, and he makes the conversion with no problem.
Tough opening spare, Jimmy, because, you know, he's starting off, he's a little bit nervous, and he gets a spare like that. He converted very nicely. Fortunately, it was a strike spare, whereas he can throw his normal shot into the pocket and still pick it up.
Yes, Gary Barbera gets to bowl in the second frame here in the second match. As we talked about, Teresa Morris finishing the sixth position. She picked up a check for $400. Billy Gum, the veteran Hall of Famer, finishing the seventh position. He got a check for $345 as Gary Barbera delivers his second shot in frame number two, and that was a great pitch for a strike.
He got a little more on that one. I think that first shot, you know, it was the first shot, jitters a little bit. He's been here before, you know, but winning before doesn't mean anything when it comes down to this part of the action, as we both, all three know. You know, every time you get to it, it's a different situation as we watch Gary Rebillot on lane 22.
Gary Rebillot on the second frame, got a strike up in the first frame. He's going to try to apply the pressure early, right down around the seventh board. Ronnie, seems like he's playing a little more outside than he did in the qualifying round.
He's throwing the ball real direct, keeping it in play, and that's what you have to do, especially in the pressure situations. He's making good shots, and he's doing the same thing against Kerry that he did against Tom Johns last game. He's immediately putting the pressure on him, and Kerry's going to have to respond.
Gary Rebillot is probably one of the more accurate players that you're ever going to see. He's got a nice, smooth style. He's extremely accurate. Nice, smooth delivery. With that delivery, you'll be in the game a long, long time. As he carries out the 10 pin, that gives him the three strikes. Freeze perfect through three.
You know, sometimes, Jim, that you'll leave that soft 10. But that's just about the way things are going for Gary Rebillot right now, because he's got the smooth stroke. He's got the nice, clean release. Watch him at the bottom of the swing, how he just lets it go. He's just making good shots right now. And then you start to trip the 10s, and you start to get the 4 out. And this should be, Gary needs to make a big shot here.
Gary Barbera bowling in the third frame on lane 22, the 1986 Wayne County Masters champion, going for two in a row. And he converts it. He's got a spare in the first, strike in the second, strike in the third. But he is down 10 pins to Gary Rebillot, who is perfect through three. Gary Rebillot is, like we say, is perfect through three as Gary Barbera comes up on the left lane. We're bowling on lanes 21 and 22 here in the Akron Open at Colonial Village Lanes. I'm Jim Mitchell. I'll be doing your play-by-play throughout the evening. And with me is Dickie Barger and Ronnie Bell as Gary Barbera comes up in the fourth frame. He's got two strikes in a row. It's early in the match, but we're in a must-strike situation already. It seems like that it's going to be like that throughout the whole evening. Didn't quite get the five out, Dick.
Didn't get the good roll. Kerry still looks a little tight, but he's just not putting a good putting a good swing on it, and that's what I mentioned about Rebillot. Like, Rebillot's got a game under his belt already, too, so Carey's kind of going frame at a time, you know, and Reb is already with a 250 under his belt, so he's applying the pressure, and it's definitely making an effect on Carey Barbera's release.
Carey Barbera, fully in the fourth frame, converts that 5-pin, gives him 69 through the third frame, with the spare working in the fourth, but his opponent, 42-year-old Gary Rebillot from Canton, Ohio, is perfect through three, bowling on the right lane, on lane 22 here in the Akron Open.
Gary's got to keep the pressure on. That's a big shot right here, folks. This is a real big shot.
Looking real smooth that time, Dick.
Got it in a little bit, huh, Ron?
Well, you notice, Dick, if anything, he just did not get the good hit on that ball. Looked like he got out of that ball a little bit quick, and the ball went out, and he didn't have the proper spin on the ball to carry that 10-pin. He's going to have to pick this up.
He will move to the extreme left side of the lane to convert the 10-pin, and he'll just slide it in. He won't put a hole out on the ball, just slide it right into the 10. Very accurate player. And he converts the 10-pin in the fourth frame. That gives him 79 in the third with the spare in the fourth. Gary Barbera's got 69 in the third and a spare in the fourth. Gary Barbera is down 10 pins. We are playing for a purse tonight, gentlemen, of $4,600 with the winner to reach $1,700. The two bowlers that we are seeing now are playing for $1,400. The loser will receive six, and the winner will keep going on as Gary Rebillot coming up in frame number five. And he strikes.
He did just what Ron said. He got more on that. It was a much better delivery, and that's why I said the shot before was a key shot. You got to keep the pressure on Carey Barbera and a player like that, don't you think, Ron? I mean, he's a great player.
Well, all these guys, you don't make an Akron Open TV show without being a great player, and they're demonstrating that right now. Carey's going to have to begin to put some more pressure, though, back on Gary right now. He's going to have to start.
Carey Barbera on lane 22, the right lane here on our TV pair of the Akron Open. Taking a little more time, he is currently down 10 pins. Bowling in frame number five. Let it go to the right quite a bit, but it made it back, guys.
He got a good roll on that one. That was a lot cleaner shot. Actually, I thought he got it in a little bit and then out. And from our camo angle here, back here, it's a little hard to see sometimes, but he had to do that, like Ron said. He's got to put the pressure right back on Rebillot because you don't want to get more than 10 pins behind Gary Rebillot.
Gary Barbera seems to be quite calm out there right now, bowling in frame number six, working on a strike. He's got 89 in the fourth, a strike working. Gary Rebillot, his opponent's got 99 in the fourth with a strike working. And again, we have a very close, tight, high-scoring match. Gary Barbera, lane 21.
Well, you can tell from his reaction, Ronnie, he liked that when he let it go.
It's the best ball he's thrown so far. You notice in the first few frames, he's become a little bit lighter than the pocket, not really extending, not really hitting the ball. That's the shot that Carey Barbera is famous for right there. He threw it good, he came through it real hard, and the results were a strike.
Gary Rebillot on the lane 22. Gary Rebillot had a 300 game here this week in the Akron Open. Looking real good. Little week 10 that time. You know, we were talking to Gary before the show, and we asked him what was the turning point for him here in this year's Akron Open, and I crossed next to him, and he shot a three-game block in there, 233, 267, and a 300. Gentlemen, that adds up to an 800 series.
Oh, when you grab 200 pins during a qualifier, that'll definitely put a little poke in your arm swing, and like Gary said, that's it vaulted him into the top 16, and then he just stayed there. Being a veteran player that he is, you know, once you give a guy like that an 800 series in a six-game block, and he's going to take full advantage of it.
Gary Rebillot coming up in frame number seven. He's got a spare working in the sixth frame right now. Gentlemen, we have a tie ball game. Gary Barbera's got two strikes working. Gary Rebillot is working on a spare, bowling in lane seven. Good pitch.
Yeah, he rolled that a lot better, huh, Ronnie?
He sure did. You know, I noticed he's having a good time on lane 21, but 22, this game is giving Gary a little bit of trouble. I think he's going to have to make a slight adjustment, maybe move his feet a little bit to the right and play a little bit more direct. Hopefully, he'll do it soon.
Gary Barbera coming up in frame number seven. He's got a double up working. He's got 89 in the fourth and two strikes working. He can take a 10-pin lead with the strike right here. Gary Barbera qualified in the fourth position after our 12 games, and he moved into the third spot after the six games in the semifinals. So, in blistering, 234 average for the 18-game tournament. There it is, three in a row, and he just kicked the lead.
He does have the lead, and 28-year-old Kerry Barbera, a former champion here, has now taken the lead from Gary Rebillot. And as we predicted, high scores. Look at the numbers, Jim.
You know, we talked to Kerry earlier in the match, or in the interviews, and, you know, he says that he can strike on this condition. He can strike here at Colonial Village Lane, and if he has any problem, it's with spare shooting. And right now, he doesn't have that problem. I mean, when you're throwing strikes, you don't have to shoot the spares, but that's something to think about later on in the match, just in case it comes down to that point where he might need a spare. Gary Barbera bowling on lane 21 in frame number 8, working on three in a row, going for four.
He liked that one. Well, we've seen a real turnabout here in events, haven't we?
Well, definitely we sure have, Dick. He's got a 20-pin lead right now all of a sudden, but Gary can respond. I'd look for this guy to throw the next two. He's that kind of a player. He'll definitely hit the pocket for sure. We'll see what he does.
This is the key shot just right now.
Gary Rebillot bowling in frame number 8. He's got a strike working, but he's down. It's, a much situation where he must strike right here. And he got that weak 10 out that time, Dickie. The situation is very simple. Gary Rebillot is going off right now at a 2.29 pace. Kerry Barbera is going off at a 2.39 pace. So, really, anything can happen.
It's going to be a nail-biter, I get the feeling.
I think he secretly heard me there, Dick. He made the proper move. He got that pinned it out.
He made the move.
Gary Rebillot on lane 21, bowling in the 8th frame, working on 2 in a row. Nice, smooth delivery. And he did. Struck again.
Well, he's got 14 years on Kerry Barbera in age, and that's all bowling experience, too, bowling fans. Gary Rebillot bowling on the tour in the late 60s. And Gary, this is all in saying this, and quite honestly, glad to see him still around.
As we have Kerry Barbera coming up in the 9th frame, this is our second game at the 1989 Akron Open. From Colonial Village Lanes, I'm Jim Mitchell, and with me is Dickie Barger and Ronnie Bell doing our professional color today as Kerry is working on 4 in a row, bowling in the 9th frame to apply the pressure to Gary Rebillot. Little high, left the 4.
Boy, have we got a match now, Jim. I think there's a 1-10 game right now. Kerry's down. Gary Rebillot, if he strikes out, Kerry can't beat him. But again, Kerry's got to pick up this spare, regain his thoughts, come back, strike out, put the pressure back on Gary.
We're in the 9th frame, and the 4-pin, Dickie's not that easy to spare. We have quite a bit of oil carry down here.
Yeah, but he's going to go real hard and direct at it, and he is not going to miss a spare, I guarantee you.
Gary Barbera goaling for the 4-pin, the 9th frame, and he makes the conversion, and the situation is very plain right now. We've got a 1-pin match. Kerry Barbera going off at a 2.38 pace. And, anything can happen here in the 10th.
Let's don't forget the possibility of a tie. It can definitely happen. Kerry goes strike spare. And Gary goes spare strike. 9 spare strike. We've got a tie.
I think with you here, Ron, there's always the possibility of a tie.
The winner of this match will go on to bowl the number 2 seeded player, the 1981 champion, Timmy Elsass. The winner, or the loser, we'll pick up a check for $600, but here we go at the 10th frame. Kerry Barbera, lane 21.
Wow. Gosh, you do that good, Jimmy. A solid 10. Boy, the bowling gods were not with him on that pitch.
That's for sure, Dickie. And the key here again is now Gary Rebillot has 2 pins to work with. He's going to have to pick this up and throw a strike. Anything can happen.
This is with a spare shooting. Now this is a 10-pin, a little more difficult. And Jim mentioned earlier about Kerry and having some trouble shooting spares. So let's see him shoot this 10-pin.
Going for it in the 10th frame, and it's exactly what we talked about earlier, gentlemen. If anything was the downfall of Kerry Barbera, it was those 1-pin spares, and especially on the corners. He threw a lot of strikes throughout the tournament. But Kerry finishes up with a 226. The situation is right now is Gary Rebillot, all he needs is a mark.
If there's anybody that can sympathize with Kerry Barbera, it's me. I missed the 10-pin against Jeff Mraz in the
1983 Open to lose the title. So it's just a tough break. Of course, Gary got a strike there. He's en route to another 250 game. It's just a tough break for Terry. He's going to have to bite the bullet, so to speak, and come back next year and go for another title.
Well, he made two great shots. He made a great shot in the ninth. He grabbed it, got all of it, left a solid four, comes right back on lane 21 and leaves us the ring in 10. So, you know, sometimes it's going with you and sometimes it's not. And as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, Gary Rebillot, with his style and with his smooth delivery, as you said, Jimmy, so many times, he's a tough player to beat, and he kept the pressure on.
Well, Gary Barbera, the 1986 Akron Open champion, will not win his second title here today. He loses to Gary Rebillot, who is currently averaging 255 in his two games tonight here on the show. Gary Barbera shoots 226. He will finish in the fourth position. He will pick up a check for $600. Gary Rebillot shoots 259 to go along with his first game of 255. He goes on to meet Tim Elsass, and we'll be back with our next match right after this. Okay, here we go. We're ready to start our third match tonight here in the 1989 Akron Open. The second-seeded player and the 1981 champion, Tim Elsass, he's got his hands full against Gary Rebillot, who is currently averaging 257 for his two matches. Tim Elsass averaged 240 for the tournament this weekend, 18 games in the Akron Open. First frame. Looks good.
A great shot by Tim Elsass as he starts off on the left lane. You know, it's interesting. The Akron Open, at this point right now, we can say, quite honestly, it's not going to be an Akron champion, is it?
That's right, Dick. And, it could be. You know, you never know. Tim Elsass, he can come right up here, and he is living in Akron now, if I may be so bold to say.
I forgot he did relocate. You're right. He is now an Akron University student.
Gary Rebillot starting out his third game here on our show tonight. Again, Gary seems to be quite relaxed starting out with his strike here in the first frame. You know, Gary looks so calm and relaxed right now. He's going to be awful tough to beat.
Well, you know, when you get his age, he's pretty content in his ways. You know, really, Reb's been around a long time. I mean, this guy's a true, true veteran in the word.
Rumor has it, though, he's still shopping in the junior section, fan. So so don't be afraid to go out there and help him out if you see him in the store.
Gary Rebillot bowling in frame number two on lane 21 here in the Akron Open. Comes up a little light, leaves that weak 10.
Didn't get a good reaction. They didn't like the shot when he threw it. Once again, we're getting started here with match number three. Gary Rebillot, Tim Elsass. Tim Elsass, former champion here, and pumped up. Let's say during the interviews, Timmy was very, very adamant about what he was going to do tonight. And as Gary converts the difficult 10-pin, and let's watch Tim Elsass on lane 22.
Tim Elsass, 27 years of age, from Akron, Ohio right now. He's formerly from Canton. He now makes his home here in the Akron area. He's, as we say, 27 years of old. He was 19, gentlemen, when he won his first Akron Open title back in 1981, and obviously the last couple of years he's been into a little dry spell, but you know, he spent a lot of time at the University of Akron. He's now graduated, and he's back to bowling real well. Bowling in the second frame, two strikes in a row, Dick.
Yeah, I didn't realize Timmy was living here in town. I haven't been following this closely as I normally do. Let that get by me, so it is nice that we still got an Akron contingent left in the tournament. Gary Rebillot, of course, from Canton, and Kenny Konzos bowling out of Brunswick, Ohio. So Tim Elsass has taken the lead here as he moves to lane 21 for the third frame.
27-year-old Timmy Elsass bowling in frame number three. He's bowling on the left lane, lane 21 here at Colonial Village Lanes. He is perfect through two, going for his third strike in a row. Timmy's high game of the tournament was 290. That was during the qualifying round. Averaged 240 for the 18 games throughout the tournament. And he comes up with strike number three. The difference in the two games, gentlemen, you notice Gary Rebillot's gone a little straighter in the pocket, whereas Timmy sort of opens the shot up. He seems to be crossing more boards to get to the pocket.
It's a smoother type shot, though, Jim. It's a little bit smoother than what Gary Barbera was throwing the last game. But this is a classic matchup right here. All of a sudden, it's the shoes on the other foot. Gary's going to have to come through and put some pressure back on Tim Elsass.
Gary Rebillot coming up in the third frame with a strike up in the third. He has a strike in the first and a spare in the second. He's got 40 in the second frame as his opponent, Tim Elsass, is perfect through three. Sort of an ironic match that we have here that Tim Elsass is bowling his idol. And Gary Rebillot, he says if he had one person he would love to bowl with, it would be Gary Rebillot, and they are, you know, friends throughout the years. You know, 42 years of age, Tim Elsass is 27, and they're just great friends, but tonight they're bowling for the Akron Open title. Gary Rebillot now has two strikes in a row, and Tim Elsass, coming up in the fourth frame, is perfect through three. Let's go through some of the other finalists, gentlemen. We've mentioned Teresa Morris finished sixth. Billy Gahn, the veteran, finished in the seventh position. Left-hander and veteran Bobby Fitt finished in the eighth position. And Rocky Heater, last year's qualifying leader, who finished second in the Akron Open, finished ninth. Akron University's Mark Bradley finished in the 10th position. Akron University's Mike Berger finished 11th. George Kitchen, a veteran, finished in the 12th position. Nick Profrock finished 13th. Akron University's Mark Hurdlick finished 14th. John Vincent in the 15th position, and our 16th and final position was Tracy Heine. So we had a tremendous field as Timmy Elsass comes through in the fourth frame. He is perfect through four.
That could be a real, real important shot there. Tim Elsass took a little more time on that shot, I think, Ron, and he didn't throw as good a shot. He laid it a little short, but he went through it. He made the good swing, and he got the big break, the trip 4-9.
What a big break right there. I mean, if he leaves a 4-9 or just trips a 4, he still leaves a 9. That's a 20-pin difference. And now, Tim's got to feel very good about it. Now he can throw up and throw a nice, relaxed shot and make a good shot. And he could come away being up 30 pins all of a sudden.
Tim Elsass bowling on lane 21 in the fifth frame. He's perfect through four. He's been down this road many times being perfect. He has 14 games of 300. Going for number five. It's a beautiful shot. He seems to be so relaxed. Tim Elsass has got three series of 800 or better with a high of 845. He is a three years. He was the Stark County Rookie of the Year. Also, he's an OTBA doubles title champion with Eddie Carter and an OTBA champion. So Timmy has quite a few titles to his credit.
At a tender age, he's got experience already as we watch Gary Rebillot.
Gary Rebillot bowling on frame number five leaves a ringing solid seven.
For the smash seven, unbelievable. Rebillot dug in deep on that one, Jimmy. I mean, you could just see at the bottom, he just went for all of it. He threw a perfect shot, what appeared to be perfect, and the solid seven, a true bowling tap. Huh, Ron?
It sure is, and it's just a tough break right now. He's just going to have to gather his thoughts, pick up his spare, just like he did, and just try to keep on going. He cannot afford to stop now.
Well, there's not much you can do when you throw the ball that nice and leave that solid seven, but it puts him in a very awkward position right now. For the first time, Gary Rebillot is behind in a match. As we say, the first match, he beat Tommy Johns with a game of 255. The second game, he beat Kerry Barbera with 259. But right now, he is down around 20 pins to Tim Elsass, bowling in frame number six. Another weak 10.
Soft 10, and well, this match is going the other way all of a sudden for Gary Rebillot. Tim Elsass, I talked with him earlier today. You know, he told me it's interesting. He's bowled 300 here at Colonial Lanes three times and over the last 7-8 years here, and each year that he bowled the 300 games, he never made the TV show. Here this year, his high game of the tournament is 290. He now has five in a row, a shot at a 300 game.
Tim Elsass coming up in frame number six. He'll be bowling on the right lane, lane number 22 here in the Akron Open. He's perfect through five. I'm Jim Mitchell, and with me is Ron Bell and Dickie Barger, and we're bringing to you the 1989 Akron Open from Colonial Village Lanes, and it's been a wonderful tournament. 96 players, 96 of the best players from the five county area. Just an unbelievable tournament that Rick Davis, the general manager and founder of the Akron Open, puts on. As we see Timmy Elsass bowling in the sixth frame, taking a little more time. He wants to make sure that he gets off a real good shot here. Perfect through five. Going for number six.
He got it to the right.
A little soft on that.
Yeah, Exactly. He got soft. He got it into the hook spot a little bit too quick, huh, Ron?
That's right, Dick. And you know the key here is that he should have left the 4-9 the last time over there. I'm not sure if he made the adjustment, whether he wanted to throw it harder or he just wanted to make a good shot. And, sometimes when you take too long, it can cost you. And I think this was the case in this frame.
That's one thing I was going to bring up, Ron. He used to take quite a bit of time and he would get in trouble a little bit. And in the last year or so, he sped up his game a little bit. He gets up, gets set, and he delivers the ball. That time, he fell right back into that old habit of taking the time. But, you know, you can't really blame him for doing that. He wanted to make sure he got off a perfect shot.
Well, let's don't forget he missed those two pins.
Very important.
That's four pins in count that he just gave Gary Rebillot back. So this game is far from over, gentlemen. We've got a real match right here, and I look for Gary to respond.
Timmy Elsass bowling on the left lane number 21, the seventh frame, a ring of 10. And what looked like a blowaway is now a 13-pin match. So now, we've got another tight game.
Well, as always, Jim, as soon as we think we've got it going one way and we make a little prediction, things bounce the other way. But that's what's so great about the sport of bowling. You can do it from the age of 5 all the way till you're 80 years old, and it's always always interesting, no matter who you are or what age you are, the great sport of bowling, a competitive sport.
Lane 21 going for the 10-pin, 27-year-old Tim Elsass. Ronnie, did he bounce that off his ankle, or what happened?
I thought he did, yes. He clipped his ankle, and the ball went in the gutter, and what a turnaround. He started with a 5-bagger, and now he goes open. All of a sudden, he's only got a 2-pin lead. He's just got to be so flustered. What do you think, Dick?
I'm just shocked. He looks so prepared, and he, you know, we go back to the tripping at 4-9. I think he should have made the adjustment on the right lane, and he didn't do it.
Gary Rebillot coming up in frame number 7. Lane 22 here at Colonial Village Lanes. It puts him right back in the ball game. Again, he's coming up with that weak 10. Gentlemen, maybe he's playing a little cautious.
I don't think so. He got a little more angle at the pocket that time. It looked like the ball entered just a little too soon, though, and he didn't get the good finish.
I think also one thing we're overlooking now is that we bowled two games on this TV pair, and now the lanes are probably changing a little bit. Gary's going to have to start making a couple more adjustments to get lined up for that championship match. And even Tim Elsass, he's going to have to move. The lanes have changed during this game, and it's whoever makes the best adjustments is going to win.
And we'll see how the two opens by Tim Elsass affects Gary Rebillot. Gary Rebillot coming up in the 8th frame, lane 21. He's got 127 in the 6th, a spare working in the 7th. Tim Elsass has got 150. Through the 7th, so we only have a 3-pin match right now, as Gary, this time, he comes up in the 8th frame with the strike, gets off the 10-pin, and it'll be interesting to see how Tim can regather himself and get back in the ball game.
Did you notice the difference in the shot Gary Rebillot threw there? When he let it go, you could just tell from his reaction, his gut reaction, he got the good roll on it. Let's watch Tim Elsass.
Again, Tim taking his time, he's trying to compose himself after those two disastrous frames in the 6th and 7th. Bowling at frame number 8. That's a better pitch. He seemed to be a little more relaxed on that shot.
He definitely worked quicker that time. He didn't take as much time. He was more aggressive. You know, that's what happens in these situations. You start kind of maybe out-guessing yourself, maybe, Ron, a little bit. You've been in this so many times, you could tell us a lot better.
Just get up there. You should have everything handled before you get up on the line. Where you're going to throw it, what you're going to do. When you get up there, you feel set, you pull the trigger. And I just don't think he did that. He had a little lapse of concentration, but I think he's back on track now.
Timmy Elsass coming up in the 9th frame. He's got a strike working in the 8th. 150 in the 7th. Strike in the 8th coming up in the 9th frame. Trying to apply a little pressure to Gary Rebillot. Good stroke. He got that ball out on the alley. That was probably his best pitch of the ball game, Dick.
Very aggressive shot by Tim Elsass, and puts the pressure right back on Gary Rebillot. And we, like Ron has said, we've got another chance for a tie.
It's incredible, but yes, we do. This is the key shot, though, I think, of the match. Gary is absolutely going to have to strike here, and to at least make Tim feel that he's going to have to perform in the test.
Gary Rebillot bowling in the 9th frame. 147 in the 7th, strike in the 8th, bowling in the 9th. There he is. Wow, that was a great pitch. Gentlemen, it's only 3 pins. Tim Elsass is up by 3 pins. Question, Ronnie. Tim Elsass had the advantage here. He opted to finish on the right lane, but don't you think sometimes that might put the pressure on you if you have to perform, put the pressure right on you?
Well, that's the idea of it, Jim. You know, they've been here all weekend, and they've seen it perform under the pressure. And now it's time. You got two guys on strikes. Tim Elsass can't lose it if he strikes out.
Wow, that was a great shot right there. Looks like he made those adjustments. That was Gary Rebillot bowling in the 10th frame. He's got 147 in the 7th with three strikes working. The best that Gary Rebillot can get is 237. He cannot lock out Tim Elsass. Tim Elsass can finish with three strikes in the 10th for 240. But it does put the pressure on him.
But wouldn't Timmy like to have those pins back and throw away now?
He lost over a mark and pin count back in the 6th and 7th frame. Gary come in a little high, and the pins are bouncing around. He leaves a solid 9. That's going to give him a 226. 226 with a conversion here. What does he need, Ronnie? Looks like he needs a mark.
He needs the first strike. He's shooting 220 right now. He needs the first strike in the 10th to win the match. So we're going to see what... It's all up to Tim. When you come to this situation, you got nobody to blame but yourself. He either wins it or he loses it, so it's going to be interesting to see.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, right down here. He elected to finish the match. Gary Rebillot has completed his work. He finishes with 226. It's very simple. Tim Elsass strikes on this ball, he wins the game. If he doesn't strike, he loses. He stayed with it, boys. He got it out there. Oh, no way. No way.
Boy, what a tough break. I mean, you cannot throw the ball any better. We saw Gary Rebillot lead one earlier in the game on a double. But now, when everything was on the line, Tim Elsass threw a great shot. You just can't throw it any better. It's one of the worst breaks in bowling. It's a good break for Gary, though. And now he's looking forward for the championship match.
Well, I tell you, Ronnie, just what a great shot by Tim Elsass, trying to win, trying to be the second person ever to repeat here at the Akron Open and the Smash 7, which, you know, Reb left one too, but that was a big, big shot there. And it's irrelevant now, folks, really. That took a lot of the air out of Timmy's tank.
Well, it's going to finish up. Gary Rebillot is going to win our third match, 226. Timmy Elsass is going to shoot 219. That means that Gary Rebillot will go into the finals against Kenny Conchos. Timmy will finish in the third position. He'll pick up a check for $800 as he strikes out his fill ball in the 10th frame, 219. In a very exciting, thrilling match. Gary Rebillot, 226, Tim Elsass, 219. And we're going to be back with that championship match for the Akron Open right after this. Okay, here we go for the final match for the 1989 Akron Open. Kenny Conchos and Gary Rebillot. These two players will be bowling for a grand total of $2,700. Gary Rebillot leads off the match with a strike.
He's glued in. It's just a matter of whether he carries or not, huh, Ronnie?
It's an important shot, Jake. You know, it's nice to get off a good start in a major game like this. Let's see what Kenny can do. He's going to have to make some good shots right off the bat. It'll be interesting.
Kenny Conchos bowling on lane 22 here on Akron Open, starting out. This is his first TV finals in the tournament, and you want to see a fine style. Watch this guy throw the ball. He's just perfect in every aspect of the game. First frame, wall shot. You know, guys, he was doing that throughout the whole 18 games. He comes in light, and he gets that great wall shot, great action.
He's got great leverage, and he's got a good shot for this house. If he gets the ball to the right, he gets a good reaction because of his power, and if he pulls the ball a little bit with the great swing that he has, it just puts the ball right back on line, Ronnie.
It sure does, and he's got enough power and enough lift on that ball to shoot lights out, and he did it all this week. Hopefully he can do it one more game, huh?
Kenny Conchos, 31 years old, from Brunswick, Ohio, comes up in the second frame, and he is perfect again. Two strikes, strike in the first, strike in the seventh, and when we start talking about Kenny Conchos' stats, it's like the who's who's in bowling. He is a PBA regional champion, and we'll talk more about Kenny Conchos as the game progresses, as Gary Rebillot now comes up on lane 22 in the second frame here in the Akron Open, going for two in a row. Still keeping the rat around that seventh board. Bad break on that one.
It was a bad break. He threw that shot good. He got good roll on the ball, and here now we're going to see right away the strategy starts. Consos has got the double. Rebillot strike nine. Let's see how it turns out.
We got to watch out for that oil carry down here on lane 22. We've been playing now for over an hour, so the oil is carried down. But Gary compensates perfectly for it and converts the seven pin, which gives him a spare in the second. With a strike in the first, it gives him 20 in the first. Conchos will be bowling in the third.
I think, if anything, Jimmy, this game, since the oil has carried down, it could favor Kenny Conchos a little bit. He's got a little bit more roll on the ball. If he gets it wide, he can get the ball back. Whereas Gary could have a little trouble driving through the pocket, and he could leave those 10 pins.
Gary Rebillot, third frame. Comes up with a strike. Gary Rebillot at both the third frame. He's got a strike in the first, nine spare in the second, strike in the third, which gives him a 40 in the second frame. Kenny Conchos coming up in frame number three. He's perfect through two. Kenny Conchos from Brunswick, Ohio, 31 years of age, had a blistering 2.46 average for the 18-game tournament. A great stylist, great leverage, Kenny Conchos.
And he carries a Wally Gator, a thin shot, and I think it's safe to say that we are going to now have a new Akron Open champion this year, and he's going to be from out of town. Am I right, Ron?
That is true this time, Dick. You're right.
Last year's champion, Dean Billings, failed to cash this year, and in 1987, and the only two-time champion, Todd Agee, he was unable to perform here. So those are just some of the past champions as we watch Kenny Conchos bowling on lane 21, the fourth frame, perfect through three. Again, using that wall shot to his advantage.
He's got it going. Well, he, you know, this guy, 840 over for 18 games. I mean, he bowled superb yesterday and today. The last game today, he shoots 180-something. The 17th game comes right back. The 18th game shoots 240-something. He starts out tonight with a four-bagger. He's looking awfully sharp.
Gary Rebillot coming up on lane 22 here at Colonial Village Lane, working on a strike in the third. And he lays it right in the pocket. Right now, Gary Rebillot is going off at a 2-0 pace, where Kenny Conchos right now is around 220. So right now, Kenny put the pressure on early, but in my opinion, Kenny ain't going to let up.
He certainly isn't, Jim. And it was important, that shot, for Gary to let Kenny know that he's still in this match and that he wants this title, too. And I think he's going to throw this strike also.
Two fine veterans here for the title of the 1989 Akron Open. Gary Rebillot, frame number five, strike. That's strike in the third, strike in the fourth, strike in the fifth. He's got 70 in the third as we watch Kenny Conchos. 26 300 games. 26.
It used to be my waist size. It's been a couple of weeks, though.
Kenny Conchos did have a 300 here in the qualifying round of the Akron Open. And he also had a 298 game, so striking is no new thing to Kenny Conchos. Came up a little high, guys.
That's oh, what a tough break there. You saw he got the ball out just a little bit too early. He didn't have the speed to hold that ball off. It hooked early, went right to the nose, and he's got himself a split where he's just going to have to get two pins on the left and just try to come back the next frame. Gary Rebillot has the lead.
It's the same as the last game when Timmy Elsass started out with striking. Then he comes up with the big split as Kenny gets two, hoping for a pin to bounce out. As right now, he's got an open in the fifth frame. He's got 115 in frame number five.
You know, what's interesting, Jim, is the fact that it seems that this year the right lane has been the lane that's proved to be the one to bounce up and surprise everybody. Usually the left lane is usually a little tougher.
That's the way it has been in the past, but obviously this is a new year, and we've got a match, guys.
Kenny Conchos, 31 years of age, from Brunswick, Ohio, bowling in frame number six. Right back in there with the strike. Kenny Conchos is, like we say, a PBA champion. He is his 800 series. He's got 14 800. I don't think we got 14 800s between us, guys.
Well, Ronnie probably has 10, and you've got four, so that gives us 14.
Gary Rebillot coming up in frame number six, working on three in a row. Currently has the lead by five pins. Takes his time, keeps the ball right around that seventh or eighth board, just lays in the pocket. Gentlemen, he's lined up.
Gary Rebillot, the vet. Unbelievable.
He's putting the pressure on Kenny Conzos. If he gets this one, Kenny's going to have to feel like he's going to have to stretch out. Gary seems to be wired in. But let's not forget, you know, he left a couple taps, and anything can happen here. We've got five good frames left, and, you know, it's going to be close. I think it's still going to go down to the wire.
Gary Rebillot bowling on the left lane, lane 21 here at Colonial Village Lane. Going for five strikes in a row. There he is. Well, you know, the guy shoots 255 in the opening match against Tommy Johns. He comes back, shoots 259 against Kerry Barbaria in a victory. He shoots 226 against Tim Elsass. And you know, gentlemen, he only made the TV show by three pins.
Incredible. You know, come right down to the 10th frame of the last six games today as we watch Kenny Conzos on the right lane.
Kenny Conzos, a PBA champion and no TBA champion. Right back in there. Gets a bad break on that, Ronnie. Solid eight.
Well, I'll tell you what. I think Gary Rebillot is living right. You came down to the 10th frame. Tim Elsass leaves a solid 7-pin. All of a sudden, Kenny Conzos has to have it, and he leaves a pack eight. Those are two things that the opponents have to leave for you to win, and Gary's taking full advantage of it.
Ronnie, right, let's ask a question here. You know, in the past, that number one seeded player in the Akron Open has had a lot of trouble winning. It's got to be tough waiting an hour, watching your opponent throw the games and then come over cold. It's tough to win from that number one seeded position, isn't it?
It sure is, Jim. And but the key is that Kenny now, he has to strike out. He can still shoot a good 245 game, and which means that Gary Rebillot will have to throw another strike. But now is the time. If he has any hope of winning the Akron Open Championship and being the 1989 champ, he'll have to strike here.
Well, he gave that one a little more room. Coming up in frame number eight, he strikes. It's like Ronnie said, he's in a must-strike situation, and he came through. As we are getting ready to watch Gary Rebillot, we've only got three more frames to go here in the 1989 Akron Open at Colonial Village Lanes. I'm Jim Mitchell along with Ronnie Bell and Dickie Barker bringing you all the action as we watch this 42-year-old Canton, Ohio player strike in the first, spare in the second, strikes in the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh frames, coming up to frame number eight. A solid strike in the eighth. Right now, gentlemen, he is going off at a 240 pace, and the best Kenny Conzos can do is 235.
He's going to have to protect this lead somehow, but the best protection is to get a strike here. And I look for Gary to throw a good shot. He's loose right now. He's got to feel comfortable. You just cannot say enough about how well he's bowled. And I have to admit, I didn't make the right pick, gentlemen, to go for it.
Yeah, it's Gary Rebillot is definitely wired in. Bowling in the ninth frame, working on six, going for number seven. That just about locks it up. Let's see, Kenny Conzos, the best he can do is what, 235? 245. He can open in the 10th. So this situation is very plain as we watch Kenny Conzos comes up on lane 22. Must strike situation. If he does not strike on this ball right now, he cannot win the tournament. Uses the wall to his advantage, and there's still hope for Kenny Conzos as he strikes up in the ninth frame.
Looking back at that solid eight that he left in the seventh frame, and you know he's got one really bad shot the whole game, and Reb doesn't have a bad shot, so that's how great these guys have bowled all weekend. And Rebillot marching from the fifth position all the way through buzzsawing through these four competitors, and Conzos has got to have this one. He got it.
He's still applying the pressure. He's in the 10th frame. Kenny Conzos is 155 through the seventh, with strikes in the 8th, the 9th, and the 10th. Again, if he does not strike on this ball, he cannot win the tournament. He's thrown a fine game. He just got that bad break back in the 5th frame. But let's watch Kenny Conzos on lane 21, the 11th shot. Must strike to have any chance to win. Solid week 10.
Well, I think we got a new Akron Open champion, Gary Rebillot. Just what a... What a fine show he put on for everybody here, and he's got to be just so excited. It's just, believe me, it's a privilege to win this tournament, and Gary's got to be feeling on top of the world.
Kenny Conzos led this tournament by 120-some-odd pins as a nice round of applause. He shoots 234. Kenny Conzos will pick up a check for $1,000 as we prepare to watch our new 1989 champion, Gary Rebillot. He will receive a check for $1,700. Yeah, Kenny bowled a great tournament average, 246, but he's going to finish second tonight. As Gary's just finishing out the 10th, he can finish out with 280. That will give him a phenomenal four-game series of 1,020.
Well, it comes out to about 255 average, Jim, and we knew it at the beginning of the show. We said they were going to be high-scoring, and sure enough, it was. And you just, you know, when you're in a final match like this, it's hard to beat a 280 game. And Gary's just throwing the ball great. He's just so relaxed. And there it is.
He's putting on a little show right now.
Yeah, he's enjoying it, and he's well-deserved, marching all the way from fifth all the way through. And our new 1989 champion, Gary Rebillot from Canton, Ohio.
Rumor has it, Jim, that Gary will be buying drinks in the lounge. It's just a rumor, but he could break that perfect record.
As we watch Gary Rebillot throw the final ball here in the 1989 Akron Open. And he comes in a little light. 278, our new champion for the 1989 Akron Open, Gary Rebillot. And now we are going to have Rick Davis make the award presentation, and we are going to stay right here. That's tournament director Rick Davis. He will be making the award presentation to all of our finalists. We're going to keep it right here as we go through it. As Rick Davis, again, puts on a fine tournament. He's currently thanking all the people who made this a fine tournament, all the scorekeepers, and all the volunteers who made this a great tournament.
Yeah, he did a great job, and the whole staff there, you know. That's what it takes, you know. It's a teamwork. Rick knows his stuff, being just winning recently himself down in Canton, a Stark County Masters champion, as Tommy Johns gets his money.
Fine champion, and Rick Davis is Tommy Johns in that fifth position. He received a check for $500. As we now see Kerry Barbera, he's going to receive a check for $600 and finishing in that fourth position. Another fine tournament by our 1986 champion. Timmy Elsass, who qualified in that number two position with a 240 average. He finishes in the third position, picks up a check for $800. And it's like we say, it is difficult to win from that number one spot. And Kenny bowled a great game. That's true. And here we are with Kenny Conchos. He's going to receive a check for $1,000. He bowled a great tournament, averaged 246 for the 18 games, but came up a little short against our champion.
Who knows what could have happened, Jim? You know, we go back 2 games ago where Timmy Elsass leaves a solid 7-pin and it lets Gary win, and now he wins the championship. What a fine champion.
We are our 1989 champion, Gary Rebillot. Yes, sir. So he definitely has the experience. So that's going to about do it for our 1989 telecast. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Ronnie Bell and Dickie Barger for doing our telecast. Any last words?
It was just a great tournament again, Jimmy, and looking forward to next year.
It's always great to work with you two guys, and you add a lot of class to this show. Thanks for letting me tag along. I appreciate it.
And that'll do it for our 1989 Akron Open. I'm Jim Mitchell, along with Ronnie Bell and Dickie Barger. Say, and we'll see you next year.